Hello friends, I am Professor Arun Nandurbarkar from EC Department, Early College of Engineering, Ahmedabad. In this session of Basic Electronics, we are going to discuss number system conversion, which is part 2. We had an earlier number system conversion, part 1, in which we had a conversion from decimal number into binary number and binary into the decimal one. Now, in this session, what we are going to cover, let us look into this. Various other types of number systems are there, which are also important as far as the intermediate conversion is concerned. And we had mentioned that hexadecimal numbers are very much used for programming the microcontroller. So we are having octal, hexadecimal number, and we will try to convert the octal number into binary and binary to octal. Thus, other type of possibility of conversion is octal to decimal and decimal to octal. And another possibility is octal to hexadecimal conversion and vice versa. Finally, binary to hexadecimal and hexadecimal to binary, and we will try to see the conversion between decimal and to hexadecimal. So friends, our first conversion is octal to binary. So now let us look into the conversion process. What is a technique for converting the given octal number into the binary number? So we convert each octal digit to its 3-bit representation into the binary notation. Say for example, we are having a number 705, which is an octal number, and we would like to convert into the binary number. So what do we do is that we try to write down the given octal number into the binary notation. So our first bit, starting from the least significant bit, is equal to say 5, and we should write down the first digit into the binary notation, and we know that 5 is represented in the binary format as 101. So this 5 is written as 101. Similarly, our next bit, which is the second bit, and it is equal to say 0, and we know that its equivalent binary number is 0000. Similarly, the third octal digit given to us is equal to 7. So we know that the equivalent binary representation of this 7 is equal to 1, 1, and 1. So we have written all the three given octal digits into equivalent binary representation. So we can write down the answer of the conversion of 705, which is an octal number, into equivalent decimal, equivalent binary number, and it is 111, 3 times 0, and 101, which is a equivalent binary number. The next type of conversion is a binary to octal. So we were earlier given an octal number, and we were trying to convert into the binary. So now it is a reverse conversion. So how do we convert a given binary number into the octal number? So the technique is simple, that we try to group the bits into the group of 3 bits starting from the right hand side, and we try to convert these equivalent bits into the octal digits. Now let us look into the example. And we are given a binary number and we would like to convert into equivalent octal number. So the number which is given to us is 1, 0, 2 times 1, then 0, 1, then again 0, 1, and then finally 1 and 1. We would like to convert this binary number into octal number. So what we have done is that we have made the grouping of the bits starting from right hand side. We have created the groups of the bits into a group of 3 bit. So the first 3 bits from the right hand side is 1, 1 and 1. So we have created that group. Then the next group of the 3 bit is written as 0, 1 and 0. And we know that the first group of bit is nothing but 1, 1, 1, and it can be represented as a digit 7 in the octal notation. Similarly, our second group of 3 bit, which is say 0, 1, 0, it can be represented as an octal number which is equal to say 2. Then our third group of the bits, which is say 0, 1, 1, and we can write it down as an octal digit is equal to say 3. And finally, we are having a single bit, so we should write down that bit and that is our octal digit 1. So we have the answer of this binary to octal conversion. So we are given a certain binary number and the answer of that octal conversion is 1327 into the octal notation. So friends, whenever we try to make a conversion, we do not forget to write down the bases over here. So I think that we were supposed to convert the given number into the octal number, and that is why we are writing down 8 at the end of this particular number, just to indicate that it is an answer which is an octal answer. The next type of conversion is from octal to decimal. What is the technique for converting an octal number into the decimal? So we try to multiply each bit by the powers of 8, which is say 8 raised to n, and n refers to the weightage of that particular bit. So weight is nothing but the position of the bit starting from 0 on the right hand side, and whatever are the results of our multiplication of the powers of 8, we try to add the result. Let us look into the example for this conversion. So we are given an octal number of 7, 2, 4, and we would like to convert into the decimal number. So as we can see that the first particular digit, octal digit, is equal to 4, and we should multiply it by 8 raised to 0 because its position is the first position. So we have to multiply it by 8 raised to 0. So answer of 4 multiplied by 8 raised to 0 is equal to 4. Then the next bit is equal to 2. So its position is the second position in this particular notation, and we have to multiply it by power of 8 raised to 1, and the answer of 2 multiplied by 8 raised to 1 is equal to 16. Similarly, the next bit in the given number is equal to say 7, and we have to multiply it by 8 raised to 2. So we get the answer of multiplication 448, and we try to add all the results and we get the answer of 468, which is a decimal number. So we have converted the given octal number into the equivalent decimal notation. The another conversion, that is the reverse conversion, is the decimal to octal kind of conversion. What is the technique for converting a decimal number into the octal number? So technique is simple. We try to divide the given decimal number by 8, and whatever the remainders are there, we try to write down those remainder, and which will represent as the equivalent octal number. Let us look into the example for this conversion. So we are given a number 1, 2, 3, 4, which is a decimal number, and we would like to convert it into the octal number. So we remember that we have to simply divide the given number 1, 2, 3, 4 by 8, and we get a remainder is equal to 2 after the first division. Then we try to divide the answer, that is a 154, by 8, and we get the remainder is equal to 2. In the third, say, division, we try to divide this 19 by 8, and we get a remainder is equal to, say, 3. Finally, we try to divide this number 2, and we get a remainder is equal to 2. So we have answer ready with us in the octal notation, and we write down that the given decimal number 1, 2, 3, 4 is represented as 2, 3, 2, 2 into the octal notation. So this 2 over here, as pointed by the arrow, refers to the least significant bit. So it should be written on the right hand side, which is written over here. And these two of our answer of division refers to the most significant bit. So it should be written on the left hand side of our answer. So we have also taken care, and whenever you try to write down your answer, do not forget to write down the first remainder of your division into the least significant bit. Another example for this conversion from decimal to octal, we are given a number 44978, and we try to divide it by 8. Our first remainder is 2. Then in the second division by 8, we get a remainder is equal to 6. So we can write down 62 as our answer. If you carry on the third division, then you get a remainder is equal to 6. So your answer would be 6, 6 and 2 after the third step. Then in the fourth row, we divided the 87 number by 8, and we get a remainder is equal to 7. So our answer is 7, 6, 6, 2 after the fourth row. The fifth row, it is 10, and we try to get the remainder, which is equal to, say, 2 after dividing it by 8, and we get our answer as 27662. Finally, in the last row, we are having remainder is equal to 1. So our answer of this number is 127662 in the octal notation. So we were given the decimal number 44978, and its equivalent octal number is 127662. Let us look into the next type of conversion, which is octal to hexadecimal. What is the technique for converting the octal number into the hexadecimal? So we try to use the binary representation as an intermediate step. Let us look into the example. We are given a number 1076, which is the octal number, and we would like to convert into the hexadecimal number. So we remember that we are going to use the binary representation as an intermediate step. So we try to write down the given octal number into equivalent binary notation. So our first bit is 6 and its binary representation is 110. Then the next octal digit is equal to 7 and its equivalent binary representation is 111. Then the next octal digit is equal to 0 and its equivalent binary is 000. Finally, the most significant bit is 1 and its equivalent binary representation is 00 and 1. So what do we do is that in the octal notation we were having the group of 3 bit, and for hexadecimal notation we have to collect the group of 4 bits. So whatever bits that we have written, we try to create the group of 4 bits starting from the right hand side. So we are getting the first group of 4 bit as 1, 1, 1 and 0, which is the hexadecimal digit E. Then the next group of 4 digit is 0011, and it is equivalent to hexadecimal digit 3. Finally, we are having the next group of 4 digits is 0010, which is equivalent to hexadecimal digit 2, and hence we have written the given octal number into equivalent hexadecimal notation. So we write down our answer of the conversion. The original number given to us was 1076, which was in the octal notation, and after the conversion we get an answer is equal to 23E, which is a hexadecimal number. The next type of conversion is a hexadecimal to the octal conversion. So how do we convert this kind of conversion? So technique is, once again, you can use the binary as an intermediate step, we can say. Let us look into the example. So what we are doing is that we are trying to do a reverse kind of conversion compared to the earlier one. So we are given the hexadecimal number and we are trying to convert into the octal number. Earlier we were given the octal number and we were trying to convert into the hexadecimal equivalent. So we are going to use the binary as an intermediate step. So what we have done is that we are given a number 1F0C, which is a hexadecimal number. So C is our least significant bit, and we write down in the binary format as 1100. Similarly, the next hexadecimal given to us is having a bit equal to 0, and it is written as 0000, 4 times 0 in the binary notation. Then the next hexadecimal digit is equal to F, and we can write down in the binary notation as 4 times 1. And finally, the most significant bit is equal to 1, and in the binary notation we can write down 3 times 0 and 1. So what do we do is that now, since we require a octal number, we try to make the grouping of 3 bits, and we try to create the group of 3 bits starting from the right hand side, and it is 100, which is equivalent to 4, that is octal digit 4. Then the next group of 3 bits is 001, which is equivalent to octal digit equal to 1. Then the next group of 3 bit is 100, which is equivalent to octal digit is equal to say 4. Then the next group is 111, which is equivalent to the octal digit, which is 7. Then the next 3 bits are basically 001, which is equivalent to 1. So we have our answer into the octal notation, that the given hexadecimal number was 1F0C, and we have converted that number into the equivalent octal notation. So our answer is 17414 into the octal notation. The next type of conversion is binary to hexadecimal. So what is the technique for making the conversion from binary to hexadecimal? We try to make the group of 4 bits starting from the right hand side, and we try to write down the hexadecimal digits. Let us look into the example. So we are given a certain binary number, that is say 101 0, 3 times 1, then 0, 1, 1, and we would like to convert it into the hexadecimal number. So what we can write down is that 1011 is the first group of 4 bit starting from the right hand side, and it is equivalent to hexadecimal digit B. So we proceed to the creating the second group of 4 bit, which is say 1011. So again, the next group of 4 bit is also a hexadecimal digit, which is say B. And finally, the third group is having only 2 bits, which is say 10, and we write down 2 as our hexadecimal digit. So our answer of binary to hexadecimal conversion is written as 2BB into the hexadecimal notation. So friends, here we remember that we should write down the appropriate base at the end of the number to indicate that it is an hexadecimal number. Now let us look into another type of conversion, which is a reverse conversion from hexadecimal number to a binary number. What is the technique for converting a hexadecimal number into the binary number? So we try to convert each hexadecimal digit into 4 bit equivalent binary representation. So the example is also, we can see that we are given a number 10AF into the hexadecimal notation, and we would like to convert into the binary notation. So the procedure is simple for this conversion. Starting from the first hexadecimal digit, that is say F, so we try to write down the hexadecimal digit F into equivalent binary number. So F is equivalent to 4 times 1. Then the next hexadecimal digit is equal to A, which is equivalent to binary representation 1010. Then we proceed to the third hexadecimal digit, which is equal to 0, and its equivalent binary representation is 0000, 4 times 0. Then the next hexadecimal digit is equal to 1, and its equivalent binary representation is 3 times 0 and 1. So our answer of hexadecimal to binary conversion is written in terms of strings of zeros and 1. The next type of conversion is a decimal to hexadecimal conversion. So how do we do the this type of conversion? The technique is we try to divide the number by 16 and we try to keep the remainder of the particular division. So let us look into the example for this conversion. We are given a number 1, 2, 3, 4, which is a decimal number, and we would like to convert it into the hexadecimal number. So as mentioned in the technique, we try to divide the given number by 16. So in the first step, 1, 2, 3, 4, if you try to divide by 16, the remainder is say 2. Then in the second step, we are getting an answer of 77. So we try to divide 77 by 2, 16, and we get a remainder is equal to say 13. Now these 13, which we get as a remainder after second division, is equivalent to hexadecimal digit capital D. And finally, after the third division, we get a remainder is equal to 4. So we have done the division by 16 for converting the given decimal number into the hexadecimal equivalent, and we have our answer. So 1, 2, 3, 4, which is a decimal number, which we have converted into equivalent hexadecimal number, which is say 4D2. So we also remember that the first remainder refers to the least significant digit, and we should write down in our answer the first bit, which is the first remainder, so that should not be forgotten. Otherwise your answers may be in the reverse order. So this alert that you have to take care regarding the least significant bit. Now let us look into decimal to hexadecimal conversion once again. So we are given a decimal number 830. We try to divide it by 16. In the first step, we get a remainder is equal to 14. Now this 14 is equivalent to E in the hexadecimal. After second division, we get a remainder is equal to 3. And after the third division by 16, we get remainder is equal to 3. So our answer is 33E into the hexadecimal notation. Now the next type of conversion is hexadecimal to decimal. The technique is simple in the sense that we multiply each bit by the powers of 16 and 16 raised to n, where n refers to the weightage of the particular bit. And weight is nothing but the position of that bit starting from the right hand side. And after multiplication, whatever results that you get, we try to add the results. Let us look into the example. We are have a number AB, which is a hexadecimal number, and we would like to convert into the decimal notation. So we start with the first hexadecimal digit, which is say C. Since its position is the first position, we have to multiply it by 16 raised to 0. And C is nothing but 12 into the decimal notation. So 12 multiplied by 1 is equal to 12. The next hexadecimal digit is equal to B. And since its position is second position, we have to multiply it by 16 raised to 1. So B is nothing but 11, and we have to multiply 11 by 16 raised to 1, that is 16, and we get an answer is equal to 176. The next hexadecimal digit is equal to A, and we have to multiply it by 16 raised to 2 because its power refers to the third position. And A is nothing but the decimal number 10, and we multiply 10 by 256, that is a 16 raised to 2, and we get the answer of this multiplication as 2560. Finally, we try to add the number and we get the equivalent answer 2748 into the decimal equivalent. So here we were given a hexadecimal number, we have converted it into the decimal notation. Another example for hexadecimal to decimal conversion. So we are given a number 3B4F, which is a hexadecimal number, and we would like to convert it into the decimal equivalent. So procedure is similar. We try to multiply by the respective powers of 16. So our first hexadecimal digit is F. We have to multiply it by 16 raised to 0. We get an answer of 15, because F is nothing but 15 into the decimal notation. Then the next hexadecimal digit is 4, and its position is the second position. So we know that position number minus 1 refers to the equivalent power. So it is to be multiplied by 16 raised to 1. So 4 multiplied by 16 raised to 1, we get 64 as an answer. Then the next digit is B, and we have to multiply it by 16 raised to 2, because it is the third position, and we get the multiplication. Finally, the fourth hexadecimal digit is 3, and we have to multiply it by 16 raised to 3, because it is the fourth position is there. And whatever is the answers of our product that we try to add, and we get the equivalent decimal number, that is 15183 into the equivalent decimal notation. So I hope that you can carry out some sort of exercises among different types of, say, number systems, starting from decimal, binary, octal, and hexadecimal. So I think that we had seen in this particular session the various types of number systems and conversion among them. Basically, in the first part, we had had a conversion between the decimal to binary and binary to decimal. And in this session, we had seen the conversion among octal and hexadecimal, as well as binary and the decimal. So basically, in this session, we had seen the conversion of the octal and hexadecimal number into various kinds of number systems. So I hope that you have understood the significance of the other types of number systems, and you can carry out the given number into another type of number depending upon your requirement. So I think that let us, before we finish the session, we would like to do one exercise in manual manner, and we can pick up the first say row for doing the exercise. So let us say that we are having a decimal number which is say 33, and we would like to convert it into the octal number. So we remember that for a number which is given in the decimal notation, we should write down the base, which is equal to say 10, and the answer that is expected is an octal number. So So we also mentioned that our answer should be an octal number, and we should indicate the base is equal to say 8. So we try to divide the number, which is a decimal number 33, and we try to divide it by 8. So after the first division by 8, 8 multiplied by 4 is equal to 32. So our first remainder is equal to 1, because 33 minus 8 multiplied by 4, answer is 32. So our first remainder is referring to LSB, which is our first remainder. Then we try to convert this further by doing the division process once again. So we try to divide 4 by 8, and we get our remainder as 4. So we cannot divide it further. So this is the most significant bit of our answer, and we say that our answer is equal to 41 into the octal notation. So decimal number 33 is equivalent to octal number 48. So I think that, friends, I hope that you have you can consider the other exercises, and you can do the conversion depending upon your requirement. And I hope that this number system conversion will be useful as far as your applications are required, depending upon your requirement. Thank you. Thank you.